When did you get home?
Just now. It's a great Christmas tree you guys picked out. What's with the other one I saw out back?
I bought it for you. And for your cottage. In case, you and Sandy...
It's okay. Hey, we can put it outside and put lights on it.
Honey, there's something I need to tell you. Last night, Jeffrey got a phone call from the police. The house that Sandy was going to buy for you.
What about it?
Well, there was a fire. The whole place burned.
Do they know how it started?
There's suspicion it was arson.
Arson?
Yeah, honey. Can you think of any reason why someone would want to burn down that house?
Ollie, Ollie.
Income free. What are we doing here? And where's Tammy?
Who?
I thought you two would be together. I mean, I talked to her yesterday. She told me she'd made her choice.
Yeah, well, she did make her choice. She chose me. She's just ashamed to admit it.
She said she was ashamed to be with you. I don't believe that.
She said that she wanted to be with me. She said she wanted to shout it from the rooftops. 5 minutes later, I hear her talking to Lizzie Spaulding, and she says she doesn't want to get involved with anyone anytime soon, like I didn't exist.
Oh, honey, I'm sure she just said that because...
Why? I mean, please, Reva, finish that thought. Tell me why Tammy can say that she loves me and then not even tell her friends.
You know how hard this is on her.
Yeah, I make things tough on him.
And you and I are used to taking on the world, but Tammy is...
Ashamed, like I said.
You remember how I reacted when you told me about your feelings? What do you think Cassie's gonna do, and what do you think people are gonna say to Tammy?
I don't care about people!
You care about Tammy!
Well, what am I supposed to do? Am I supposed to let her keep me in the dark along with the rest of her feelings?
You have to understand what she stands to lose. Everything could change for her.
And not for me? I mean, don't you think it costs me something waiting for her to come around like this? Watching her make the mistakes with Sandy? I mean, Reva, what more do I have to do to show her that I'm right for her, that it's fate? When we're together, it's simple. You know, well, it's not simple, but it's real, and it's right there. And as soon as somebody else comes in, her doubts come up, and... I can't do that.
What are you gonna do, Jonathan? Jonathan!
I can't imagine why anyone would want to burn the house down. It must have been an accident.
I'm sure. Wires or something. It's just a shame. It was so cute. You know, the kind of house you could imagine...
Mom. What?
You bought a tree for a house that I was never gonna live in.
My dream of that house burned to ashes the day of my wedding. Maybe it didn't for you.
I don't want you to make a choice that you might regret.
I've already made my choice.
To what? Be alone? Honey, there are so many things that I wish for you.
Like what, Mom? The big fancy wedding, the cottage, the golden retriever, 2.5 kids. Maybe that's not what I want anymore. I've tried to tell you, Mom, my dream has changed. And I need you to let go of yours, okay? I need you to let go.
Well, maybe I'm not ready to let go. And that's a mother's prerogative. But I can tell you this, whatever you want, that is what I want for you. I'm always on your side. I promise. Always.
Was I pushing you just there?
It's okay, you weren't.
I think I was.
Maybe a little.
What was that?
The wind?
Sounded like footsteps.
This old house makes new noises every day. All right, I have to put another load of wash in, or RJ will have nothing to wear tomorrow.
Okay. Jonathan? Are you out here?
Jonathan? You here? Scared me. Why didn't you say anything?
I think you've been saying enough for both of us. I heard you talking to Lizzie Spaulding. She asked you if you were dating. You didn't say a damn thing about me.
Jonathan.
You tell me you love me and then you act like nothing happened.
No, that's not a... Okay. I said that to Lizzie, but only because you know what a blabbermouth she is. And if I had told her about us, then everyone would have known about it in 5 minutes.
So what? Who cares? What if you were talking to someone else? Marina, your mom? Would you have told them? No. I didn't think so. You're ashamed.
No, Jonathan, I'm not ashamed. I am scared, Jonathan. I'm so scared. I do want to be with you. I do, more than anything. I just don't know how people are going to react.
So what? Who cares about that?
I care. Maybe I shouldn't, but I do. Just left my mom. She knows about the fire.
What about it?
Nothing, really. But it made her think about the house, how it would have been perfect.
Yeah, for you and Sandy.
Sandy's not even the point. It's about what she thinks of me, and... I don't want that anymore. I don't want to be that person anymore.
Then don't be that person anymore.
But that's the person that my mom still thinks I am. I've changed. But the people around me, the people around us, they haven't. And they still have these expectations and these ideas about who we are and what we should and shouldn't
be. Well, that's their problem.
No, Jonathan. It's our problem. We can't just pretend like the rest of the world doesn't exist.
Why? It's worked for me so far.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't think so.
Your life can be whatever you want it to be. It's your choice.
I know. I know, and I chose you. I did. All I'm asking is that you give me a little bit of time. Please.
Why? So you can change your feelings again and run away?
No, I'm just scared. I told you, I don't know how else to say it. I'm scared.
Wanna see scared? I'll show you. Scared.
Hey! Jonathan! Crazy. That water's freezing. You can barely swim. All right, okay. Here.
I did that to show you a point. You gotta face your fears. You can't run from them. I was scared to go in that water, and I promise, I'm just as scared as you are to find out what happens when everybody finds out about us.
You are?
Yeah, I am. But it's not gonna keep me from you. Fire, water, hell. Bring it on. I just wanna be with you.
I wanna be with you too.
Shh. It's okay. Nothing. Doesn't matter. Only we matter now, yeah?
Let me know there might be hope for me, yeah.
can bless the water, but it wouldn't turn the wine. Yeah, a picture of the sunset hanging there in your eyes. Could it just be some compromise?
Ignore it.
It's yours.
Oh. Oh, damn.
What? Who is it?
It's private. It might be Ava. She was dealing with a gas leak at Outskirts before, so.
You have to answer.
Hello?
Jonathan Randall?
Yeah?
This is Detective A.C. Mallett, Springfield PD. Your name came up in an arson investigation I'm working. I need you to stop by the station and answer a few questions.
Now?
Unless you want me to come to you.
No, it's okay. I'll be there in a minute.
Well, see you soon.
No.
Yeah. I don't. I have to. It'd be quick. Oh. I will be right back. Okay? Oh. Come here, Blondie. I hate leaving you. Detective Mullet called. He said, come down to the precinct. Something about, a fire.
Detective Mallett? Are you sure? Because I haven't seen him around here. I don't know, maybe he went out on a call or something. You know what? I'm familiar with the case. I can go ahead and take your statement.
I don't do that kind of stuff anymore, MC. I've, turned over a new leaf. I've seen the light. Hallelujah.
Wow.
Yeah.
That just sounds like a miraculous turnaround.
Yeah, it's something like that.
Now tell me, how did this happen? Was it the love of a good woman? Well, you know, Jonathan, all I can say is I hope this turnaround sticks with you, because women don't really go for that self-destructive lying type for very long.
Tammy, may I come in? You come here often?
Sometimes. This place has become like a kind of hangout for me, you know, like a place to get away from,
I saw you in here with Jonathan.
Look, Sandy, I don't want to talk about this with you. You and I are over, and I don't want to talk about this.
I'm not angry, if that's what you think. Because I know what's going on inside of you, probably better than you do. You're mad at me for not telling you about Ava, and this is your way of getting back at me.
What? This has nothing to do with you.
Oh, I think it does. What better way to hurt me than turning to Jonathan?
I am not with Jonathan because it's rebellious or to get back at anybody.
Are you sure?
I love him. I guess I always have. I loved him even when I thought I loved you. I was just too afraid to admit it.
And why is that? If what you have with Jonathan is so amazing and real and strong, it seems to me that you should be running through the streets shouting it with a megaphone. So why haven't you told anyone?
What's going on, Firebug?
Why would you call me that?
Drop the act, Jonathan. Unlike Jeffrey and the cops, I know the whole story. I know that you got upset because you thought Tammy had blown you off and you'd gone back to Sandy, so you went to that house that he bought for her and he tried to burn it to the ground. How am I doing so far?
It was an accident.
A pretty serious accident.
Well, the insurance will cover it. No harm, no foul, right?
Wrong. Look, you told me that loving Tammy was going to change everything for you. I wanted to believe that. I wanted to believe you.
Well, believe it.
How can I? Should I? I helped you. I helped you and Tammy get together. Now I'm wondering whether I made a huge mistake.
You don't trust me anymore? Don't help
me
anymore.
I'm on your side.
Oh, yeah, right.
Listen to me. I want you and Tammy to have a chance. But not if you're going to put her in some kind of danger.
Well, don't you think I worry about the same thing? I know who I am, Reba, and I know what I have with Tammy. And I know that I'm lucky she's even given me a chance.
Then don't screw it up.
I'm trying not to. That's why I went to the police station.
What for?
They called me in about the fire. Look, don't worry. I'm going to keep Tammy totally out of it. I'll take the blame. I'll even confess if I have to.
Oh, yeah. Okay, fine. So what about the next time? What about the next time you get ticked off at the world? You going to hurt someone or something again? Or can you try to control yourself? Can you do that?
I can if you can.
Fine. Play the hypocrite card. You always do.
Well, it works. You always do. Come on, look, I'm going to do everything I can to show Tammy and you and everybody else that I'm good for her, but it's all I can do.
That's a lot.
Or maybe I'm wrong and you have told everyone about Jonathan. And we both know why you haven't, because you're ashamed.
No.
You're ashamed of the kind of person he is, and you're ashamed of your feelings for him. Because you know what you feel for him is wrong.
No, it's not. It is not wrong.
And you know it will end badly. Deep down, you know that. How could it ever work with Jonathan? He devastated your family. He destroyed your life. I was there. I pulled you out of the lake when you didn't want to go on. I pulled you out of bed when you wanted to hide forever. Jonathan did that to you. The way I hurt you is nothing compared to the way Jonathan could. And you know that. So how could he ever give you what you need? How could he ever be the kind of man you need him to be?
He loves me. And I'm not embarrassed by that.
Then why are you hiding out here?
I'm not hiding.
Okay, right. So you were going to tell your mom, but you just haven't got around to it yet. You think she'll ever accept your choice? Wow, that'll tear her apart. You might as well just rip her heart out. Things will never be the same between you two. Being with Jonathan will cost you everything you care about. Everything. Is he really worth it?
Do everything that I can to protect Tammy, Reva. I am going to make her happy and keep her safe, and I'm going to be the best person that I can be for her. And I don't know where we're going to live, but thank you. I don't care. It doesn't matter. We'll work it out. Because I love her, Reva, you know? And I know Cassie's not going to be too happy about it, but eventually she'll see. Everybody's going to see that I make Tammy happy.
Mm-hmm. There still is a chance for us, Tammy. I know there is. Do you want to be with someone who you can love freely out in the open? Or do you want to keep hiding out here in the dark?
Enough! That is enough! I love Jonathan, and he loves me. And I will tell everyone, okay, in my own time, in my own way. But there's nothing you can say that's going to change my mind.
Your relationship with Jonathan is sick. and it's doomed to failure, and we both know that. If you were as confident as you say you are, you would have already gone public. But you haven't, because you're afraid, as you should be. See you soon.
Let me know there might be hope for me, yeah. Hope for me, yeah.
Hello?
Hey, sweetie, it's me.
Where are you?
Out. What's up?
Well, Jeffrey has just officially moved in. We're pretty excited, so we're gonna have a tree trimming party tomorrow night to celebrate. Will you come?
Sure, of course.
Great. Bring whoever you want. Love you.
Okay. Love you. What about this guy you maybe like?
I don't wanna talk about it yet.
Are you afraid to like him because you might get hurt, or maybe because of what other people will think?
What other people will think?
Well, you know, I mean, it's so soon after Danny.
Oh, you just mean, like, the people will scream rebound. I don't know, maybe there's a little bit of that.
So say everybody is against you and everybody you care about disapproves. Should that matter?
No, it shouldn't matter. But how are you supposed to survive as a couple when all of your friends and family want you to fail?
Maybe what you're feeling just has to be stronger than what everybody else is saying. Maybe you just have to know in your heart that he's the one for you no matter what.
It's tough, huh? Wanting so much to be together and not being able to let on.
Well, it has to be like this for a while. Tammy's not ready to tell everybody yet.
I think she's mostly worried about her mom.
You came around. You're my mom.
Yeah, but Cassie and I are different.
Yeah.
Maybe it's just harder being the girl's mother. I don't know.
Well, you saw that I make Tammy happy, and Cassie will see it too.
Reba.
Hey, Frank.
Jonathan?
What's up, Chief?
I'd like to ask you a couple questions. Have you been around Duran Lane recently?
What's this about?
Well, I'm sure you heard there was a major house fire. We're suspecting arson.
Yeah, I heard about it, and just like I told your daughter, I had nothing to do with it.
Well, the house belonged to a friend of yours, Sandy Foster.
Well, Jonathan just...
A woman was hurt in the fire. It was a neighbor.
How badly?
She survived, but she's still in the hospital, though.
Sorry to hear that.
Yeah, well, you're going to be real sorry to hear that she gave us a perfect description of someone leaving the scene of the crime. It was a tall, white male, long brown hair, your build. He was also accompanied by a white female, pretty, blonde hair. Any idea who that could be, Jonathan?
Jonathan wasn't
anywhere. No, it's all right. Okay. You ask me anything about the fire, and I'll tell you what you want to know.
I don't know if any relationship is meant to be. I used to think that Danny and I were... I don't know. Tammy? Tammy? Hey. What, something wrong?
No. I hope not.
Jonathan didn't do anything.
Reva, I'm talking to Jonathan right now. See this woman? She was going to go to bed, so she got out of her bed to turn off her TV. And while she was up, she smelled smoke. And she decided to go outside and help.
And she saw a guy that could have been me.
No, she saw a guy who could have been you and a girl. And then she saw the couple fleeing the scene of the crime in a car. A car that matches a description of your vehicle. Jonathan.
Give me a minute, okay?
Frank, just let me have a minute. Come on.
What are you doing? I can't believe you're calling me from right there.
Don't look in my direction. Just meet me at the fishing shack, okay?
Okay, what's going on?
I'll tell you when I get there. Sorry, I had to call outskirts. We're dealing with a gas leak. So where were we?
We were just leaving. Unless you have a warrant, Frank.
No, Reva, I don't have a warrant yet. But I do want some answers.
Okay. You got them. I admit it. But those witnesses are crazy. I set that fire all by myself. And I'm not going to share the glory with anyone.
You have to go?
Yeah.
Is everything okay?
I hope so. You know, it's easy to give up and to say that a guy isn't worth it if other people don't understand him. But if you understand him, that's what counts.
Maybe. I mean, if you're already involved, but I'm not.
But there's something about this guy that makes you want to be with him, right?
He's fun. I mean, I just want to have a good time right now. You know, I'll be able to cut and run at any minute.
But what if he's the one?
But he's not.
How will you know if you just walk away?
You know, you seem a little quick to throw yourself back out there. Is there something you're not telling me?
Yes. You?
Yes.
Does it scare you?
Yeah. You?
Totally.
Bet you're gonna go after it anyway.
I have to.
See, I don't.
That doesn't mean that you won't.
No, it doesn't. So, you got anything else you want to tell me?
Yeah. We should both be braver.
See ya.
So that's it. You don't want an attorney? You are confessing to the arson right
yeah,
now?
Yeah, why not? Everybody knows I'm a firebug.
Why are you doing this?
Well, he's gonna figure it out anyway. Look, I'll give you whatever you want on one condition. You just give me an hour to take care of some business.
No, actually, you're gonna do a little business for me right now, and that is I'm gonna read you your rights.
Frank, just wait. You want him to think that you did this. Why?
Well, the evidence is overwhelming, right, Chief?
So you just assume that everybody's gonna think you're guilty? Let me see that.
I can't think. Those
no,
are my notes.
Frank, just let me see it. So this is the time that you claim it happened.
Yeah, it's not a claiming, it's a fact.
Well, it's not possible. Jonathan couldn't have done it. He was with me at outskirts at his bar. We were having drinks, and there were plenty of people there that can back that up.
But he just said...
I know what he said, Frank, but don't you get it? People have been pointing their fingers at him since he was a baby. So he's just assuming that you're going to pin this on him anyway, so he's just going to confess to it. He's not going to fight it, but if he's not going to fight it, then I will. Are you going to arrest him now or not?
No.
Good. So get out of here.
Reba.
Just go before you confess to another crime you didn't commit, and I'll take care of the chief here.
I'm not advising this.
Thank you. If you're not gone by the time I get to three, one,
okay,
two...
Okay, all right.
Hey, Jonathan. I'll be in touch.
So, Frank, who else have you questioned about this besides my son? Exactly. Nobody. You just jumped right to Jonathan, right? He didn't set that fire. And you don't have the evidence to prove it. And if you try to come up with evidence, I'll sue you.
Fine, Reva.
Where are you going?
I'm gonna check your alibi.
Thank you.
Where are you, Jonathan? Jonathan. Oh, where have you been? Oh, I was so worried about you. I saw you talking to Frank earlier, and I thought for a minute that maybe...
Mm-hmm. You thought right. He was asking me about the fire at Sandy's place.
Was he talking about arson?
Mm-hmm. Apparently some neighbor lady came over to try and help. She kind of got hurt. She's in the hospital. Don't worry about it. I told him that I did it and that I was there alone.
What?
I don't want him coming after you, so I owned up to it, and then Reva came in, gave me this alibi, but I don't know. I don't know if I'm gonna let it stand yet or not.
You have to. You'll go to jail.
Well, look, the only thing I care about is you getting blamed for this. You had nothing to do with the fire.
Neither did you. It was an accident.
I lit the torch.
You also tried to put it out?
Oh, that doesn't matter. Come on, I mean, besides, we just left. We didn't even call the fire department.
You were freaked out.
You have to promise me you'll never tell anybody that we were together that night.
Jonathan.
I don't want you getting blamed for something that I did.
I won't lose you to something like that. We have to figure out what to do.
Hey, it's okay. I did it.
I can't believe you're taking the blame just to protect me.
Tammy, I'd do anything to protect you.
See? This is the Jonathan I wish everyone else could see. The Jonathan nobody knows. They did, they would know why I love you. Well, I wish everyone else could see what I see when I look at you.
I wish I was the person that you saw.
Stop. Hey. You are. You make mistakes sometimes, but you're good. You wanted to stay and put out that fire, but I was scared and I made you leave.
Stop. This is something that I did. Let me deal with it, okay?
You want to protect me?
I have to.
How can you keep giving and giving and I don't give back?
What are you talking about?
People should know about us. I should tell them, but every time I start to...
You tell them when you're ready. It's okay.
It's not okay. It's not fair to you. I mean, we're out here hiding and we should be out there.
It's enough. It's more than enough. It's okay.
Okay. It's my mom.
Yeah.
Hey, what's up? Are you busy right now?
Not really, why?
Can you come over? I need to talk to you about something.
What? Is this about the party?
Sort of. Can you come or not?
Yeah, sure, I'll be there soon. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, too.
Someday my mom will call and ask us both to come over.
Someday. That's enough. Well, I don't know. I think I'm always gonna want more.
Again.
Hello, Mother.
Why did you confess to Frank?
Why did you butt in with that phony alibi? Did you ever think I might have a plan?
Oh, I know what your plan was, to protect that pretty blonde accomplice Frank mentioned.
Tammy had nothing to do with the fire. Her showing up probably stopped me from doing
something. Burning Sandy's house down.
Yeah, well, the point is, I didn't do it. A spark must have caught on the curtains or something, but it was an accident.
Then why didn't you say that?
Who's gonna believe that? Come on. I lit a torch in the house. Besides, it's better to just take the rap and keep Tammy out of it.
Too late. Cassie knows that the police already suspect you, and so now she suspects you too.
Does she know about
Tammy? Not yet, but it's only a matter of time before she figures it out.
Shouldn't be like this. I want Tammy, that's all. She's everything to me, and when we're here alone, I can keep her safe.
But I can keep you safe. Let me help you, but we have to get this whole fire thing straightened out first.
It's too late, Reva, I confessed.
No, I can handle the cops, and I can get things smoothed over with Cassie, too.
How?
I don't know. I don't know. I haven't figured it out yet.
Oh, let me do that.
Hate these things. Just when you think you've got it all straightened out, there's another mess, another tangle worse than the last one.
Okay, what are we really talking about here?
Jonathan.
What about him?
We were wrong about him, Tammy. I thought he was trying to change, but he's not. Maybe he can't.
Mom.
I know what I know, Tammy. Jonathan's the same dangerous kid he was when he tried to ruin your life. Cassie doesn't want you at her home.
She said that?
She's having some holiday party with family and friends. She didn't want me to invite you. Did Tammy mention anything about it?
No.
Well, she probably can't decide what to do.
Well, it's not like I care about some stupid party.
I do! You belong there.
Oh, not if it's gonna hurt Tammy. Reva, I'm tired of seeing the people that she loves tear her apart. If she asks me, I'm gonna say no.
And what? You'll sit out in the snow again like you did last year?
Hey, the snow's good for those hot flashes. You should join me.
One day, everyone is going to accept you as a part of this family.
I want that. I want that for me and you and for Tammy. Especially for Tammy. Come here.
Mom, Jonathan is not the person that we thought he was.
Oh, Jonathan is just as twisted as he ever was.
No, he's been good to me.
Well, if so, then it was an act. I really think it was an act, because the fire at the house, Jeffrey thinks Jonathan set it.
Thinks or knows?
It doesn't matter. Jonathan is trouble, Tammy, period. Do you remember what he did to you, what he took from you? It took you months and months to recover from that. What about what he did to me? He tried to ruin my wedding. He ripped this family to shreds, Tammy.
And he's sorry. He would never do that again. It was a mistake.
I think he's the mistake. And I wish he would just disappear.
Mom, how can you say that?
Listen to me. You are just starting to get over what happened at your wedding. You're starting to smile again, and I will not let Jonathan take that away from you.
He won't do that, Mom.
That's right, he won't, because you are going to stay away from him. And I'm going to make sure he stays away from you. I don't want him in this house. I don't want him in our lives. As of now, Jonathan Randall does not exist.
Well, you certainly are not the best looking Christmas tree I've ever seen, but I kind of like you. A bit scraggly. But you got fight in you! And you're certainly not the first tree anybody would pick for Tammy, but I think she's gonna like you too.
And I'm gonna make sure he stays away from you. I don't want him in this house.
I don't want him in our lives. As of now, Jonathan Randall does not exist.
You know she has a ton of those ornaments already, right?
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, I figured couldn't hurt to start fresh.
You're right. It can't.
So, you're just out here, walking around?
I had some things to figure out.
Any luck?
I think so. Jeffrey, I'm glad that you and Mom have a chance at something good. You both really deserve it.
As of now, Jonathan Randall does not exist.
Hey, I didn't know you were.
We bought a Christmas tree.
Yeah. I thought we could hang stuff. I don't know, whatever.
Trim
something.
It.
Yeah, like that. This is Peter Collins.
Oh, Peter.
Do people usually name their Christmas trees?
Not usually, but why not?
Why not? Why not, Peter? How is talking to your mom?
Fine.
Yeah? She's getting ready for her tree trimming party?
Yeah.
Yeah. Did she tell you that, she asked Reva to tell me not to come?
You could say that.
So what happened?
She knows about the fire. That you're the prime suspect. She's decided that it means you're still dangerous and that it's only a matter of time before you hurt our family again.
Oh, hi, Peter. I'm Ellen the Bucket. That must have been fun for you tonight, huh? Sitting there while your mother ripped me apart?
Loads.
And what did you say?
Nothing. It's hard, Emily.
I know.
It's gonna be tough.
Yeah, your mom's trying to break us up. She doesn't even know we're together yet. It's gonna be tough.
Then we were never easy.
No. But this is a whole new level.
I want you. Right, no doubts.
You sound so sure of yourself.
I am. Now.
Now? Did something happen that made you change your mind?
No. I mean, Well, kind of. I saw Jeffrey Christmas shopping.
Oh. Jeffrey O'Neill, president of the Sandy Foster fan club?
No, forget that. He just looked so cute with all of his presents, and he couldn't stop smiling.
Yeah?
He's so happy with my mom. He just wants them to be together, no matter what.
Okay, great. Peter, doesn't that sound great?
That's what I want for us. No matter what. You should be at my mom's party tonight, and even if we're not ready to face the world, you belong there.
No. Peter and I are gonna do something different.
You come with your mom.
No, look, Tammy, I'm not gonna sit there with my mother and drink eggnog and pretend that I'm some distant cousin of yours.
Jonathan.
No, I'm not gonna do it. It's fine. I know you're not ready to jump in the fire, but...
No, it's not that I'm not ready. My family... My mom's had a really hard time, so let's just wait till after the holidays to spring us on them, okay? But I promise you.
Whoop, blah. No promises. That's our deal, right? Come here.
Someday it is always gonna be like this.
What are you doing?
Hold on. Go sit over there.
What?
Go, go, go. Go.
What's going on, Peter? What are you, taking a picture?
It's not just any picture. This is for our Christmas card next year. Smile.
Next year?
Yeah, well, it's too late for this year. Why do you look so surprised?
I am a little...
Why?
I don't know. You say it like you're pretty sure it's gonna work.
Well, I'm not making any promises.
No, I didn't think that you were.
We'll see how it goes, right?
Yeah, we'll see.
And then next year, we'll be prepared. Ready?
Yeah. Okay. Perfect is a good word.
Don't you think you're a little biased?
Okay. Come on, you gotta go. Over the river, through the woods, and all that jazz.
Isn't that Thanksgiving?
I don't know.
Anyway. Yeah, still have a few minutes.
Look, your mom, she'll come around, okay? We have Reva on our side, and that's pretty good.
I hope so. Just don't want anyone to get hurt, that's all.
I don't want you to get hurt.
I wish you were coming with me.
Me too. You walk much? It's all right. It'll only be a few hours, and then I'll see you after.
Okay.
Get your coat.
Thank you.
Hey, Josh, what are you doing here?
Well, I'm here to meet a city guy to talk about possible renovations. What are you doing here? Are you okay?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I came out here just for a walk.
Yeah, she was walking on the dock, and I was walking on the dock, and then, so, here we are.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, we get along okay now.
You do?
Yeah, nobody would get that.
No, I don't think anybody would. But then again, that's not really my business, is it? So you guys do whatever you want to do, as long as you're okay.
Thank you, Uncle Josh.
For what?
For being so cool.
I'm cool. What do you think about that, huh?
You're freaking me out. Look, I wasn't planning on doing anything bad to her. You gotta know that.
Okay.
I was actually thinking that, you know, maybe I could kind of fix some of the things that I did in the past, you know?
Yeah, well, that's the tough thing about the past, you know? You can't really change it.
No, but you can, you can try and make up for it. You can try.
Yeah, you can try.
Yeah. Serious, Josh. I would never hurt Tammy again.
What the hell? If Tammy can forgive you, I guess I can forgive you too.
Yeah?
Why not?
I wish everybody thought like that.
Yeah, well, you know, what other people think, that's not really your problem. It's their problem. Right?
My old motto.
I'm really glad you're here, sweetie.
Me too.
You want some hot chocolate? We just made it.
Not right now. Thanks.
Would you do me a favor? Would you help me get the food ready? I'm a little behind.
Yeah. Mom, I need to talk to you about something.
Can it wait till later?
No, it can't.
Okay. What's up?
It's about the fire at the cottage.
What about the fire?
You need to know what really happened that night.
What really happened?
The truth. I need to tell you the truth. I need to tell you the truth.
Tammy, do you know how that fire started?
Jonathan started it.
No,
Tammy.
Didn't.
He was seen at the house, and we all know it's not the first fire he set.
So he's made some mistakes like everyone else. Mom, he has changed.
I wish I could believe that.
Happy holidays.
You invited him without asking me?
Don't blame your mom. I came on my own accord. I heard about the party and I had brought something for the tree.
Thank you. Did you come for any other reason?
If you had a minute to talk, I wouldn't mind.
He is here already.
Well, it's freezing out, so you can come in for a little while.
Thank you.
My mom's handling all the tree stuff.
No, you open it. Please.
It's very, Sandy.
And there's more. See? New divorce papers.
I told you, I'm not gonna...
The lawyer messed up, Tammy. Jeffrey's helping me out now, and as soon as these are filed, I'll be a free man. And there'll be nothing to stop you from letting me put that ring back on your finger.
And I don't want to make it worse... But I don't want to give you any false hope either.
Tammy, we...
Let me finish. It doesn't matter now if you divorce Ava or not. You and I are over.
We can't be. I swear to you, we can fix this.
Face it, Sandy. There was always something missing.
And you really think you have it all with Jonathan?
I think you should go.
Take a look around. Do you think Jonathan will ever fit in with your family on nights like these? He'll never fit, period. I mean, he is your cousin.
I don't want to talk about it anymore.
Wait.
Let her go.
Sandy, no!
Sandy?
Oh, my God. Oh, I'm so glad you're here.
What's going on? I'm shaking.
Dream in there. Sandy showed up and tried to give me the wedding ring back and tell me that we could get back together. And
Sandy, can you hang the angel up high for me?
You, I don't want you to go back in there.
Jonathan, I have to.
I'm tired of the have to's. I want to spend every day with you all the time.
Me too. Look, I'll go back inside for a little while and then I'll come up with some kind of excuse and come find you in the barn. Okay?
Okay.
Okay, I won't take very long, I promise. I'll bring mistletoe.
Well, like we need it.
Tammy, look at you. You're all flush. Are you freezing?
Oh, I couldn't come back inside. It's so beautiful out there. You should see it.
Gosh.
Why? You said it was so terrific out there.
Well, we haven't finished trimming the tree yet. Hey, RJ, where's that star that goes on?
Here we go.
Yay! Good job, buddy.
I'm sorry if my being here upsets you.
I don't see you leaving, though.
I can make you happy again. I know I can.
I'm happy now.
With Jonathan. Well, can you do this? Can you hang on to the ring and think about it? Can you please do that?
Deck the halls with boughs of holly, fa la 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 la. 'Tis the season to be jolly.
We can at least sing a carol together, can't we?
Don we now our gay apparel, fa la 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 la. Troll the ancient Yuletide carol, fa la 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 la. See the blazing Yule before us, fa la 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 la.
Can't end the party just yet. This is a once-a-year thing.
You're in a good mood.
Well, I wasn't before, but you guys have been so nice to me, I kind of want to keep the ball rolling. There's all this fresh snow outside. Why don't we go sledding?
Now?
RJ says the best hill's right behind the barn.
You know what? I think it's a good idea.
Yeah.
Are you up for this?
I'm in.
All right, where are the sleds?
In the barn, there's a whole bunch of them.
Ah, oh, cool. Let's go get them.
Come on, let's go.
Wait a minute, where's Tammy?
She's out there somewhere. You know how much she likes the snow.
Get the hell off my daughter!
Cassie. Cassie.